glory to God. And lastly, there's the sincere hearers. And those are the hearers that have good ground. Those are the ones that say, God, I don't know how I'm going to do this, but I'm trusting you. Lord, I don't know what to do, but I'm going to listen and I'm going to hear, glory to God, what you say. I'm going to hear what the woman of God said, and then God, I'm going to obey. And Father, if I fall, I'm going to get up all over again. See, you got to make up in your mind, I know this is God. You got to know that the enemy will do anything and everything to stop you, to block you, to sabotage, hallelujah, to frustrate you. So you got to have a made up mind, a determination, and a tenacity. Some of us were fighters in the world, and then we get saved and we become spiritual wimps. Get everything. But you got to tell yourself, I'm going to do this. I might fail one time. I'm going to do it. I might fail two times. I'm going to do it. I might fail three times. But I'm going to do it. Because God said so. Hallelujah. And when you have that kind of attitude, you will not fail. Hallelujah. 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 He will take you through. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Obey. My God. Obey. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus said, why call me Lord, Lord, and you don't do the things that I tell you to do? If you love me, keep my commandments. Oh, where the Lord knows my heart. You know your works too. Yes. Well, it's thank not you. By works of righteousness. Show me your faith.
Yes.
And I'll show you my works with faith. See, it's easy for us to say we're something. When we don't have no works to prove it. Hallelujah. I've learned that if you just obey God. Hallelujah. He'll change your circumstances. He'll change your situation. All you got to do is obey God. Stop trying to take things, matters in your own hands and obey God. Glory to God. He is the one that knows the beginning from the end. Glory to God. And he's already got it worked out. He just needs somebody who will stand in the gap. Somebody who will pray, somebody who won't take down, won't give up, won't give in. Glory to God, who will take a stand. Somebody who don't mind sacrificing. How many people in here don't mind sacrificing for the Lord? Don't raise your hand if you do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sacrifice means you're willing to give of yourself. It means you're willing to give of your talents. See, some of us are talented, but don't nobody know except the people on our job. Something's wrong with that. We don't want to work in the household of faith, but we'll go on our secular job and we will work. Well, what is wrong that you can't work in the household of faith?
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. God wants us to sacrifice for our church. He wants you to sacrifice your time. Don't say, well, I'm just too busy. Somebody told me it was a family member. I'm too busy. I'm too busy to go to Bible class. Too busy to pray. I'm just too busy. And I said, well, I bet that if you get a call tomorrow, and the doctor said, you got 3 weeks to live.
Go ahead, teach us.
My God.
You won't be so busy. Anything that's important enough for us, we'll make time for. So when we use that excuse, I'm too busy, what you're really saying is, I don't want to do that. We might as well just tell the truth. I don't want to do that. That's just not who I am. And I've learned that if you really love God, if you're really connected to God, then you're going to stay in his presence. Yes. Amen. Won't nobody have to beg you, glory to God, to come to Bible class because you want to know God. You don't want to be like Samuel. God, hallelujah, glory to God. All of us start out like that. Amen. But a year later, you ought to know something about him.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
5 years later, you ought to know something.
Amen.
You ought to have some kind of power.
Yes.
Glory to God. You ought to be able to be obedient to God. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
Glory to God. We ought not to be spiritual babies all of our Christian life.
Yes, yes.
You gotta grow up.
Amen.
You gotta grow up. Yes. And the way you grow up, you gotta be able to
hear
and
obey.
You gotta
hear
and obey.
There is no other way.
Yes. Right.
There is no other way. There is no other way. Yes, you're going to have to sacrifice. And guess what? You're going to have to give your money, too.
Amen.
Yes. I ain't giving my money. I don't know what they're doing with it. They ain't doing nothing but stealing it. Who knows what they're doing with the money? The Bible says that when you give, God blesses you. See, people get it wrong. They think that they are giving. Praise God. For the pastor. You giving for you.
Amen.
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 Right.
Amen.
That's right.
My God.
You give because the Bible says give.
That's right.
And it shall be given unto you.
Yes.
With goodness.
Yes.
Press down. Shake it together. And run it over.
My God.
So you're giving for you.
Right.
So that you can give, have things given back to you, pressed down, shaken together, and run it over.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You heard the word. You got to obey the word.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. The word of God said, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. But then, here's where you come in. And prove me now herewith and see if I would not open the windows up and do what?
Pour
it out for who?
Me.
Go ahead.
Yes. So you're giving for you.
Yes.
Amen.
When you come to Bible class, you ain't coming to Bible class for God. We already know his word.
Amen.
Come on, y'all. You ain't even coming for the pastor. You coming for you. So you know how to deal with life.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. When you come to prayer, you ain't coming for God. You coming because you need something from him.
That's right.
We got this whole thing backwards.
Yes.
We got it backwards. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his
righteousness.
And what happens when you seek him?
All things
will be
added.
So the reason why we're not receiving from the word is because we haven't really heard the word. And when we heard it, went in here, came out this way. Careless hearing, you know. You know the careless hearing. And then when we do hear it, even if you don't understand it, and pray, but still
obey.
Amen.
And God will do the rest. What time is it?
Amen.
855. 8. Oh, I did good. Didn't I do good? They know their pastor. Didn't I do good? Y'all hear me?